Is real purpose of Mueller investigation for Mueller to destroy evidence of Hillary Obama criminal activity? Is the special investigation created by former Obama and Hillary lackeys from the FBI and Department of Justice, not only an effort to find dirt on President Trump and his administration but also to destroy records that would lead to Obama or Hillary crimes? We already know that former FBI head and current special counsel in the Russia investigation Robert Mueller is a bad cop. Dash. As reported at the GWP, you can't tell a bad cop just as easily by what he doesn't do as what he does do. As an example, the following major scandals and likely crimes that Mueller did not meaningfully investigate as FBI director resulting in no arrests and no consequences. Emailgate, 2007. Discovery that several top Bush administration officials violated the Presidential Records Act by using an RNC server for email communications while conducting official business, followed by the deletion of millions of the same emails. IRS targeting, 2010 to 2013, the IRS intentionally selected and then delayed or denied tax-exempt 501c3. applications from conservative groups to prevent them from participating in the 2012 election, followed by IRS agent Lois Lerner invoking her Fifth Amendment privilege against self-incrimination. Fast and Furious, 2010, this ATF program, which seems to have served no rational purpose, allowed over 2,000 guns to be purchased illegally inside the United States and then walked into Mexico for use by criminals, one of which was later used in the 2010 murder of border agent Brian Terry by the member of a Mexican cartel. Associated Press Spying, 2012, the Department of Justice illegally seized the communications of AP reporters made during April and May 2012, allowing the DOJ to unmask journalists' confidential sources. Clinton Foundation Pay for Play, 2009-2013. During the period in which Hillary Clinton held the office of Secretary of State, the Clinton Foundation and Bill Clinton received millions of dollars in paid speaking fees and a $1 million gift from countries involved in matters with the State Department, many of which had ties to terrorism and human rights abuses. Some of these funds were apparently diverted from charitable causes to personal expenses, such as Chelsea Clinton's 2010 wedding. Russian uranium deal, 2009-2013, Hillary Clinton's State Department approved a deal allowing a Russian company to control 20% of the uranium mining production capacity inside the United States, which was followed by millions of dollars in donations to the Clinton Foundation from people associated with the transaction. Clinton Private Email Server, 2009-2013, during her entire tenure as Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton dodged Freedom of Information Act requirements by using a private email server to conduct official government business, as well as sent and received classified information that was top secret over an unsecured system, an extremely reckless, and obviously illegal, act. Mueller, by not upholding the law in these cases above, created a two-tiered system of law in the U.S. laws for the political elite and laws for everyone else. Mueller's actions with legal cases are similar to the actions of the fake news media. It's not so much the lies that they report, but just as dishonest and evil are the good news stories about President Trump that they don't report. Mueller has many conflicts of interest, and even liberal publications like the USA Today reported in June that Mueller should step down as special prosecutor because of his conflicts of interest with the investigation he is carrying on. Special Counsel Robert Mueller has a problem. He has a disqualifying conflict of interest regarding a large part of his work. It involves a choice between investigating or relying on former FBI Director James Comey, a longtime close friend of Mueller's. Ideally, he'll recognize that and resign. But if he doesn't resign, Attorney General Jeff Sessions should appoint another special counsel to take over the obstruction of justice part of the investigation, where Mueller is disqualified. By not stepping down, Mueller shows that he is indeed a bad cop. A person of integrity would easily see his conflicts of interest and would recuse himself. Additional justification for Mueller being a bad cop is related to the personnel he has hired to assist in the Russia investigation. Special Counsel Robert Mueller's 15 attorneys are a who's who of liberal activism. Here is a summary of the Mueller team. Robert Mueller, special counsel team leader. Best friend to fired leaker James Comey, a key witness in the case and cohort at the FBI in assisting Mueller with many of the cases noted above. Rush Atkinson, an attorney on detail from the Criminal Division's Fraud Section at the Department of Justice. Donated $200 to Clinton in 2016. Peter Carr, DOJ spokesman under Barack Obama. Andrew Goldstein, a public corruption prosecutor on detail from the U.S. Attorney's Office in the Southern District of New York. Worked under Trump basher Preet Bharara in the liberal New York Southern District. Adam Jed, an appellate attorney on detail from DOJ's Civil Division. Defended Obamacare at the DOJ. Lisa Page, an attorney on detail from the FBI's Office of the General Counsel and a former trial attorney with the Criminal Division's Organized Crime and Gang Section, investigated Ukrainian oligarch Dmitry Firtash, a one-time business partner of former Trump campaign manager Paul Manafort, at the DOJ. Elizabeth Breelager, an appellate attorney on detail from the Office of the Solicitor General. Fluent in Russian. Former law clerk to Justices Ruth Bader Ginsburg and Elena Kagan. James Quarles, a former partner at WilmerHale and a former assistant special prosecutor for the Watergate Special Prosecution Force. Former assistant special prosecutor on the Watergate Special Prosecution Force. Jeannie Rhee, a former partner at WilmerHale who has served in the Office of Legal Counsel at DOJ and as an assistant U.S. attorney for the District of Columbia. Rhee is a Clinton Foundation lawyer and former Deputy Assistant Attorney General in the Office of Legal Counsel under Barack Obama. Brandon Van Grack, an attorney on detail from the Justice Department's National Security Division. Led a grand jury inquiry in Northern Virginia scrutinizing former Trump associate Michael Flynn's foreign lobbying. Andrew Weissman, who is on detail from the Criminal Division's Fraud Section and who has served as General Counsel at the FBI and as an Assistant U.S. Attorney for the Eastern District of New York. Weissman donated $2,300 to the Obama Victory Fund in 2008, $2,000 to the DNC in 2006 and at least $2,300 to the Clinton campaign in 2007. Aaron Zebley, a former partner at WilmerHale who has previously served with Mueller at the FBI and has served as an assistant U.S. attorney in the Eastern District of Virginia. Worked with Robert Mueller at the WilmerHale firm. Aaron Zielinski, an attorney on detail from the U.S. Attorney's Office in the District of Maryland. Worked under Assistant AG Rod Rosenstein in Maryland. Zainab Ahmad, a top national security prosecutor on detail from U.S. Attorney's Office in the Eastern District of New York. Michael Dreeben, an appellate attorney on detail from the Office of the Solicitor General, described by former colleagues as one of the brightest criminal law experts of the past two generations. Now we even know that Mueller was involved in an investigation in the FBI that was hidden by the Obama administration and only recently released in the press. This FBI investigation occurred while Mueller was head of the FBI and Mueller himself even was handpicked to deliver uranium to the Russians and to have the transfer occur on an airport tarmac. It is very clear that Mueller is a very dishonest, bad and morally corrupt cop and he should not only recuse himself from the Russia investigation, he should be under investigation himself for all of the above items. Now we also have to fear that he is in the process of destroying documents that would easily lead to his arrest while pretending to be a special investigator. God please bring this country justice. President Trump please initiate an independent investigation into the real Russia-related crimes.